can be done all year round. So with tips on having herbs for every season, Carson is back. Is it herb or herb? What do you guys say? Herb? Herb?
So I grew up in an area that was heavily German, and it was herb.
Herb. Yeah. I say herb too. How about you?
I like herb. Herb.
I like herb too. Herb. Okay, we're just gonna get rid of the H.
But yeah. My neighbor's herb, so
just saying. Don't insult the neighbor. Trouble.
Exactly.
Right.
So I've done a lot of these projects in the past. So yeah. I've done the ice cube trays. I've done the yes. olive oil with your herbs. I've yeah. done, you know, the canning, the preserves. At the end of the day, I end up with stuff left over my fridge because I forget about it.
Yeah, yeah, me too.
Right. I have trays of basil chopped up in my freezer right now from 2 years ago.
Yep.
Because I don't think about that when I'm cooking. Right. I think about, whoa, I need an herb. Go to my herb drawer, and that's what I grab. And I don't think, oh, I want fresh, I want best. So let's
you.
Talk about making this as easy as possible for everybody in the ways that I personally do it.
Okay.
Because my garden's exploding right now. How's yours?
It is out of, you gave me a bunch of stuff from your nursery, and it is like
superhuman,
taken over and
right?
dominated.
And Tracy's front yard is the same I drove by the other day. I was like, wow.
It's wild.
That's crazy.
But we like it like that, but it's abundant,
exactly.
right? Like we have to stay on top of it with the weeding.
But you also want to take advantage of it. You don't want that mm-hmm. stuff to go to waste. I mean, it's great in the compost, I understand, but you grew it for you, so let's
yeah.
use it, okay? So the first thing that I like to do is I like to do the dehydrator. Now,
okay.
the reason I use dehydrator with all of my herbs is because I can turn it on and forget about it for 3 or 4 hours, and I
right.
come back and it's done.
Mm-hmm.
So really, when you're using a food dehydrator, you're just gonna take leaves off, and you're just gonna lay the leaves on there
okay.
and do racks. Now, I like to keep all of the same herb on the same rack, and the reason why is if you do forget about it, it gets super brittle, and then sometimes they break. And then you've got things mixing up and you're like, okay, now I have Italian seasoning because I got 5 different things all in here. But if you keep them on separate trays, it makes it a lot easier. And
okay.
then one tray might be done faster than the other, so you can take that tray out and let the system just keep going.
Okay.
Now, these dehydrators, have you used one before, Scott?
I haven't.
Okay. Mm-hmm. They are amazing. All they really do is you just put a lid on like that.
Now I want one.
You turn it on to the temperature you want, plug it in.
Okay, we're gonna get one for you, Scott.
It's blowing hot air, and that's all it does.
So it just dehydrates.
It just sucks the moisture
food
out.
Food dehydrator
that's it.
And jerky maker.
Right?
So you can do this with anything. It'll make your
exactly.
jerky. How long does it usually take?
So for big leaves like a sage, you're looking at 3.5 to 4 hours on
okay.
a low heat. Low and slow, just
wow.
let it go. Do it Saturday morning, come back Saturday night, and you're ready.
Yeah.
For some of the leafier things like the basils, the parsleys, 2.5 hours is fine.
Okay.
If you don't have the fancy food dehydrator, we're just gonna put that over there.
Yeah.
You can do the same method with a sheet pan in the oven.
Yes.
Okay.
That's what
and
I know.
That's what you do too?
Yeah.
Okay. So, and I just do my coriander and I just put it on the sheet pan, spread it out a little bit in the oven, 200 degrees, 2.5 hours.
Yep.
200, 2.5.
Yeah. If you have a convection oven and you can get the wind moving in there,
yeah.
obviously
yeah.
it's going to cut down your time. It dries them out significantly faster.
Yeah.
Okay.
So if you're going to go convection route, check it every
Stay
45
on top
minutes.
Of it.
Yeah. Because you don't want like, paper at the end. Although,
yeah.
then you don't have to grind it, so maybe you do. There's options here. A lot of people now are really into fresh herbs, and I love that idea, and they want to bring it indoors. So, one of the tricks that I learned is when you have your herbs, you put them in the mason jar,
mm-hmm.
you put them in the fridge.
Yep.
We've all done that.
Oh my gosh, that
Easy.
Good.
The
I
basil,
know.
Right? Okay, here's how you're going to take it and double the life of your
That's
plants,
so good.
Though. Okay? Plastic bag.
Yeah.
You're going to trim it down a little bit. So, we're going to use some of these for the salad. Trim that down, plastic bag over the top of it,
yeah.
right like that, and we're gonna put a rubber band around the bottom.
Okay.
What happens is you've created a little perfect terrarium. It keeps the moisture and the humidity in. It actually is going to extend the life of these herbs so much longer.
Do you put that in the fridge?
In the fridge.
Oh.
Yeah, absolutely. So it's
okay.
great. Yeah, so that's gonna work really simply for you, and it's things that you have in the house already. Rubber
right.
band, bag, mason jar.
So you've tried that, it works, you love it.
I love it.
Anything to extend them, because you don't want them turning into slime.
Exactly.
You know, you wanna be able to use as much. It's the worst, it's just a waste.
Exactly. A lot of people are asking me, can I bring these inside now?
Yeah.
Well, absolutely you can bring herbs inside, but they need a certain amount of sunlight.
Mm-hmm.
Remember, most of these are Mediterranean, so they like hot and dry.
Okay.
If you're thinking about transplanting, there's a couple of tips I've got for you, okay?
Yeah.
The first, I love these self-watering systems. Now this one, you actually just take the pot, you just take a little wicking system like that in, you stick it up into the hole like that,
mm-hmm.
and then this goes down into a water reservoir, kind of like that. keeps it watered. There's a little moisture gauge.
You
don't have to do
cute.
Anything. So you can go away for a few weeks and it just keeps watering it.
Yeah.
But let's say you want to get a little fancier. Okay.
Right.
So we're gonna take this out.
That's nice and low tech.
Right?
I like that.
I'm gonna pop this lemongrass out.
Very
lots
aggressive.
Of roots in there.
Be very aggressive with your lemongrass.
You got your nice, yeah. You got your nice little flower pot. The biggest mistake people make with herbs is when they plant them, they fill it with soil.
Mm-hmm.
Don't fill it with soil. Fill it with sand instead.
Really?
Sand is better around the edges of the herbs because it helps dry them out. Remember, these are Mediterranean plants. They're not North American plants for the most part.
Okay.
The sand actually keeps it nice and dry around the sides. We tend to overwater herbs when they're indoors.
Yeah.
They don't want as much moisture as we tend to give them. So just go with sand instead of soil. They'll be happier.
That is so cool.
Yay.
You want your herbs to be happy, right?
Well, you want to eat happy plants.
You want to eat happy plants. Really good lesson there.